There, at the center of a field, starkly lit by the low sun, stood a rickety 30 by 30 foot wooden tower. It had no doors and 8 slits evenly spaced around the third story. They hesitated. They'd seen some signs of kobolds on their way here. And when the rogue inspected the tower, he had to shift his head to avoid the glare. That's when he noticed the shadow of the tower reached all the way to the edge of the field. Oh, perfect, he thought, and used the shadow for cover as he snuck towards the tower. Puzzle failed. Kobolds are light sensitive. 6 kobolds split moved to the slit, each taking a shot and darting back into full cover. The rogue has good AC, but, you know, 6 bolts, he nearly drops in the first turn. The design of Rickety Tower is truly sinister. 6 attacks per turn, the only way to hit the kobolds back is to use a reaction, and even then, they're in half cover. So, what do you do? I know what my fucking sorcerer did. He essentially ended the fight in 2 turns. Hello and welcome. Last time we went over a cantrip, so today let's talk about one of my favorite first level spells on the last episode of season 1 of the animated spellbook. Let's talk about sleep. The sorcerer knew it was the right play because the kobolds have low HP, were huddled close together, and just out of sight. He targeted a point in space from which the spell's 20-foot AoE would blossom. He rolled 5d8, the total amount of HP's worth of creatures that this spell would affect. It doesn't do any damage, but starting from the lowest HP creature working upward, subtract their HP from the roll. Then move on to the next until what's left of the roll is less than the creature being affected's HP. In this case, kobolds have 5 HP each, so he rolled a 28 and put 5 out of the 6 kobolds out in an instant. The remaining kobold, a coward by nature, left his friends to die. There's no save, a lot of creatures are immune to it, but goddamn, sleep is a good spell. Holy shit, this series is doing way better than I ever imagined. You can check out my Patreon video, link in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode of the Animated Spellbook.